Picture a small, chubby baby with soft curls, big brown eyes, and a cute button nose. How adorable! Now picture 250 babies. Cuteness overload, right? Turns out that's how many were born worldwide each minute in 2018. Babies here, babies there, babies and poop-filled diapers everywhere. Now close your eyes and imagine what 130 million of them would look like. That's how many are born yearly. If trends continue, this means the world's population will swell to 11 billion by the year 2100. But what if things changed, and changed drastically? Today we'll consider a rather strange scenario. What if women stopped having babies? Now let's begin with a disclaimer. We on the Infographics show love babies just as much as the staff of any other YouTube channel, but our job is to explore sometimes uncomfortable yet intriguing real or imagined events, like what if women, for one reason or another, stopped giving birth? You must admit, the question is a good one. Of course, what followed after would depend somewhat on the underlying reason. For example, perhaps some global epidemic killed off some of the population and left the rest incapable of reproduction. There are already diseases out there that spread quickly and can prevent pregnancy. Tuberculosis, for instance, can lead to infertility in both males and females, though not very frequently. It is highly contagious, though. Simply coughing or sneezing is enough to pass an infection on to others. So maybe an even more potent superbug with multiple mutations will develop that's immune to any form of treatment, with much greater effects, and that will spread virtually everywhere. This is not really much of a stretch. Due to continual overuse of antibiotics and the production of resistant strains of all types of diseases, or the random and continuous occurrence of mutations. Further, living situations will only become more crowded with time. In the case of a drug-resistant bug, it could spread anywhere and never stop spreading. So a serious sickness of one type or another, as remember, TB was just one example, and there are others out there, could theoretically destroy fertility and bring about the end of babies. Though there are alternative possibilities. It could also be the toxic buildup or overexposure to endocrine disruptors that throw hormones so out of whack they are no longer capable of creating children. There are many chemicals we come into contact with on a daily basis that function as estrogens or female hormones, androgens or male hormones, or thyroid hormones. These knock the body's natural balance off tilt. BPAs in plastics, DEHP in food packaging, and phytoestrogens in such things as soy are a few examples of such substances. In the future, they may become more concentrated in the environment and all around us, or as the population grows and pollution goes up, we may simply become more susceptible to them as we are bombarded with various wastes from every direction. Not to mention the effect that these other substances will have on us and our hormones. We all know how critical hormones are to the function of the human body, not to mention reproduction. These scenarios are just some of the many possible ones out there, and let's say, for the sake of argument, that they make it so that women couldn't support a pregnancy even in the instance of an embryo transplant. Further, that science has not advanced to such a point that babies can be manufactured in a test tube. We're talking a real, true end to babies without an ability to do anything about it. As a consequence, both situations would have quite a psychological impact as couples try to get pregnant but then find themselves unable to produce a child. This could lead to feelings of anxiety, frustration, and even depression. Infertility has been known to tear couples apart and destroy relationships, marriages, and families. It could even lead to an identity crisis of sorts, as women are no longer tied to procreating and childbearing. This would also blur the lines of how men and women are different. In some ways, this could be a good thing and lead to more equality, with women no longer staying at home or primarily raising the children. However, many men and women alike would feel like something in their lives was missing. An absence of babies and young children would cause a decrease in happiness for a lot of people, at least for a time. However, eventually most couples will come to accept that they will remain childless. In the case of extreme hormonal problems that lead to infertility, it could create further problems and interfere with libido or any desire to be intimate with a partner. Imagine for a moment a world without sex or desire. Without a way of finding pleasure and reconnecting with one another, or reducing stress and anxiety. Now imagine women with chronically low or high estrogen, hello PMS for a lifetime, that's right, a 24/7 moody significant other, and don't think men wouldn't be the same. With low testosterone, they would become less strong and aggressive, too much, and they may become risk seekers and more likely to engage in criminal activities. In other words, without healthy hormones, we would be quite a mess. According to Dr. Amy Kaler, an expert on social structure, it's likely that we wouldn't even last the estimated 100 years it would take us to naturally die off following the end of baby making without sex. In fact, she has a reason to believe we'd all kill each other long before then. Beyond family and social structure, the economy would falter a bit as well. Businesses depending on babies for their products and services would find themselves struggling. This includes such things as daycares and infant-themed stores. In time, it would encompass schools and even sports. As yet further time passes, there would be no younger generations to take care of the aging population that remains. Government programs to provide for seniors would collapse without a strong new workforce. Not to mention, for many, retirement would never be possible. Life would become unrecognizable without many capable of completing anything requiring physical strength, keen eyesight, or sharp mental abilities. Toward the end, many would suffer. However, not all the changes would be negative, or at least not at first. Babies, after all, are rather pricey. The U.S. Department of Agriculture estimates that a middle-income family in America spends $14,970 each year per child that they have. To support them until they turn 18, that adds up to a total of $245,340. That's definitely not chump change. While this exact figure varies by country and region, parents across the globe will doubtless agree that having kids is anything but free. Without having to provide for babies or children, many people everywhere will have a lot more disposable income. This in turn means that what they would be spending on their kids' clothes, extracurriculars, and education can now go toward their own quality of life. They may splurge more on themselves and purchase more high-end luxury items. There would be more time to relax and kick back after a day of work, instead of scrambling to bathe little people, get them dressed for bed, and then tuck them in to sleep. Before they age too far, they'll have the ability to live a much cushier life if they're smart about it. Of course, the mentality of the very last generation may also change, and thereby alter everything. Their work ethic might go out the window, as they realize that no matter what they do, it will have no lasting impact. Improvements will be somewhat pointless, as after they've died, there will be no one left to enjoy them, as well as conservation. After all, what need is there to limit wastes or pollution when everyone is going to disappear soon? Though some may still consider the remaining animals and plants, others won't find them compelling enough reasons to limit their activities. No matter the choices made, after the last babies are born in roughly 100 years or less, all people will die, humanity will end, every last memory of us will fade into nothing. Then comes the question of what would happen to the Earth, depending on if there's much of an Earth left. Discover magazine looked at the Demilitarized Zone, or DMZ, in Korea to answer the questions of what would likely occur in the absence of humanity and the years that followed. The DMZ, after all, has barely been touched by people since 1953. What was once long, long ago a site of agriculture is no longer. The rice paddies are now marsh, and large flocks of some of the rarest birds thrive there. It's clearly doing just fine, if not better, in our absence, and erasing any impact we ever had there. Though many believe it cannot truly resemble wild nature until 100 or more years after humans vanish completely from even the surrounding area. In other words, dams must be broken and animals must be free to roam without human intervention of any kind. Without humans anywhere at all, expectations are that wild meat eaters would eat off the domestic animal populations and dogs would also in time disappear. Experts don't believe that even feral canines could compete with the true wild predators in Korea. A war of species would then continue. Those native to the location would be in direct competition with exotics brought in from elsewhere. Humanity's mark of various genetic modifications would all in time be lost, and purebred horses would revert back to true wild species still present in parts of Mongolia. In 100 to 200 years, all the breeds made by man would be replaced by original species. In thousands of years, the DMZ would resemble the world as it was before mankind ever existed. The theories of what would happen once humans are gone that are tied to real-life examples continue. It's believed that plants would overtake entire cities, much like the ancient ruins now covered in jungle several centuries after the decline of the Mayan civilization. This includes even the largest, most built-upon locations. The cement pavement of New New York City, for example, would soon crack and widen due to changes in the weather of the seasons. Soon, plants would begin to grow up in these spaces. The most aggressive exotic tree species of the area, the Chinese ailanthus tree, would cause sidewalks to erupt and sewers to burst open. Gutters would fill up with debris and water levels would rise and new bodies of water would form. The 30 or more streams present before the Dutch came centuries prior would slowly reappear. In time, New York would suffer the same fate expected of San Francisco. Both will go down in flames. San Francisco is even more at risk due to its countless historical and fire-friendly buildings. But in New York, fires will likely occur after the ignition of countless piles of leaves in a lightning strike during a storm. Not to mention, in time, lightning rods on New York City buildings would rust and no longer be effective. An earthquake could also hit the state. If not, bridges would collapse over a much longer period of time. But again, it's not all bad. Without heated buildings, our demise would bring about the end of the infamous and, by all accounts, indestructible cockroach. Native to Africa, the pests won't be able to survive the frigid New York winter without us. Rats would also be hard up to find an easy meal without festering human leftovers to feed them. Like the animals of the DMZ, pigeons would return to their rock dove ancestry. Heavy metals left behind by humans should gradually be broken down by plants. However, things such as petroleum or other chemicals may leave a deadly mark for a great long while. There is hope here through precedent. A chemical weapons plant in Denver from World War II was deemed to be the most contaminated place in America by 1984. Now, it's a natural refuge for wildlife. So, though we will leave behind several foul reminders of our presence, in time, nature should come out on top in the end. So, to sum it up, no more babies will lead to many changes in human society. We may become more reckless. Overall, we'll be less happy, and in time, we'll become quite helpless as the population ages. We may stick it out for almost a century or take each other out long before then, depending on whether or not we still engage in sexual activities. Hopefully, we won't destroy Earth too much in the process. Once we're gone, things will go back to how they were before we came. However, this will take quite some time. At least wherever we go, we will be taking some darned cockroaches along with us. So tell us how you would feel if you were part of the very last generation of humanity. Let us know in the comments. Also, be sure to check out our other video, What Are the Chances of World War III? Thanks for watching, and as always, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. See you next time!